Good morning, and viewers. And welcome to Better Faith e-learning platform. My name is Ms. Blessing Edosa, and I'll be taking you on biology this morning in SS3. Last week, we talked on genetics, we talked on the definition of genetics, we spoke on different terms used in genetics, and listed some. I explained briefly about Mendel's law of genetics. Today, I'll be deliberating more on the method Gregor Mendel used in carrying out experiments under genetics. So today, we're going to be talking about the method used by Mendel. The method used by Mendel in his experiments. You know, Mendel or Gregor Mendel is a monk from Australia, a scientist, which is officially known as the father of genetics. He made experiments of how traits or how genes have been transmitted from one generation to another. Okay, on that he worked on an experiment by using the pea plants. He used the pea plants to know how genes or how characters are transmitted from generation to another. He was curious, needed to know how does these characters in human are being transmitted to their offspring. So he worked on a garden pea. But one of the reasons why he used garden pea plants was the pea plant is an annual plant, which means it can produce yearly. It produces and dies within a year. He uses it because it's an annual plant, it has a short lifespan. Another reason is because garden pea can self-pollinate itself. It undergoes self-pollination. And also he also uses his hand to cross-pollinate the plant. Another the third reason why he used garden pea plant was that garden pea plant has different characteristics, beautiful characteristics. Some of the seeds are brown, some are red, some are yellow, some are green. Some of the plants are wrinkled, some are fresh. Some are just different colors and different shapes. That was why he used the pea plants to know how genes are transmitted. So by using the pea plants, that led to the stating of the monohybrid inheritance and the dihybrid inheritance. He used two methods to conduct this experience, the two methods, which is the monohybrid inheritance and the dihybrid inheritance. What is the monohybrid? I would say monohybrid inheritance. Mono, it means once, according to the word mono. Mendel used artificial methods to cross two different kinds of plants. At a time, which differs in one pair of contrasting character. He used the pea plant, remember, I said he used artificial method to cross two different plants, which differs in one pair of contrasting character, which is the tall and the short plant. He used both the tall and the short plant. And the tall plant is indicated by a big letter C. This for the tall plant. Why no letter T indicates the short plants? So, he carried out the experiment in the following ways. How did he carry out the experiment? First, he planted the tall plant for some time, for several generations. He planted this tall plant and observed that the plants produced were all tall plants. He planted the tall plant and he observed that all the products was tall. And then also he planted the short seed and for several generations as well. And he observed that all the pea plants, the one he produced, their offspring were all short plants. So then he proceeded to plant both the short and the tall plants together on the same farmland. He planted the tall and the short plants together in the same farmland. He called the pulling grain. He collected some pulling grains from the tall plants when the top plant has produced, when they have the both plant has produced flower, when they have grown to an extent, it collected the pulling grain from the top plants and it pollinated it with the stigma, which is the female of the short plant. I don't know, I remember I taught you the last time, in our previous thing, I taught you both what pulling grains and stigma means. It collected the pulling grains from the top plant, from the flower of the top plant, which is the male, pulling grain is the male. Then it pollinated it with the short plant, with the stigma of the short plant. Then then vice versa, it collected also the pulling grain of the short plant and pollinated it with the stigma of the top plant. That was how what he did. Then what did he do next? Then he then covered, after he pollinated, he cross-pollinated both of them. He then covered them artificially. He covered the plant artificially, he covered the flower with a small nylon bag so that they will not cross-pollinate naturally, so that insects will not come to disrupt his experiments. He covered them so they will know when they produce, he will know, yes, this is what I did. So he covered them. That was the reason he covered them. Then after that, he once again picked the seed form after the cross. When he has finished crossing them, when the plants grew, he picked the seed from both the short and the top plants and planted it. And planted it together. As when he planted it, when he planted the both the tall and the short plant, the seeds, the product of them was all tall plants. They were all tall. They produced all tall plants, which is the dominant. So that the tall plant was now the dominant gene over the short one, which is the recessive gene. So that led to the first filial generation. What I have been saying is, he planted top, this is top plants. He planted top to get the first filial generation. Then he planted short plants. Okay? Then, they produced, they both produced. Remember I said he collected the sigma, he cross-pollinated both of them. So when they want to produce, they both produce top plants. So these short plants, recessive gene, and this is what the dominant, because all the product was what they all top plants. This one is the first. This is the first filial. It is indicated like F1, first filial generation. After he has crossed both the tall and the short plants to produce the tall plants. Then later, what he did then he then crossed the first plants. The product of these tall plants, he then crossed them. He took plants, he took seeds from this tall plant that they produced and crossed them. And he then planted their seeds and sold them. The plant he got from them was all but was both tall. To go further, he planted the tall plants. And this is the F1. And another two tall plants again. And pollinated this together. Then what he got was, it was now. He now got three tall plants. Three tall plants and one short plant. Okay, I know you are confused. You are confused. Let me explain it in a better form. Okay, what he did was, this is the first one. This is the parents. This is the parents, and this is the top plants. At first, he generated the top plants into the short plants. So when they produce, now let's cross them. This one means this. To give you C. Then this same one meets the second one to give you big and small. Then this second one meets this to give you big and small. This and this meets this to give you big and small. So you can see from the products, this is the first generation. So if you notice it, the genotype here is now what? Genotype plants, the first one is what? Of all the first filler generation, this is the first filler generation. Of all the first filler generation, is what? All tall plants. Which, because if you notice it, this is C, C. If you can observe it, they have all, this big letter indicates tall. If you notice it, there's tall plants in all of them. They all have tall plants. No short CC. They all have, why the phenotype, that of the genotype, they are all tall plants. Why the phenotype here? The phenotype is what? It's, they are all tall. It's very obvious now. They are all tall plants. But they are what? But there's something that occurs. They are not just fully tall, they are heterozygous. When we say heterozygous, it means they are not pure breeded. If you notice, they have a big, the small one. It's not a big, when they say homozygous, it means they are not 100% the gene. But if you have something like this, double C, it means they are homozygous. This is heterozygous because they're homozygous because the both of them here, they are 100% tall. But here, they are not 100% tall, so it's heterozygous. It is, this one is not pure breeding, but this is pure breeding. So the result here, if you notice it here, if you notice it here, it's what? It's not, it is what? It is heterozygous. Heterozygous. Because they are not pure breeding. Now let's cross, this is on the third generation. They then went further. They then went further to cross the product of the first generation. This is the product of the first generation. So it crossed the both the tall ones, the C and the C. It crossed the left cross. We have here C, C, T. Then here again. C, C. Then here. C, C. Then here. Small C. If you notice it, the genotype here is now, this is the second, that's the first filler generation, this is the second filler generation. But the genotype of the plants, plants are, let's call it genotype. This means the gene of the organism. Let's talk about the genotype now. So we have, it's now it's one ratio, two ratio, one half. We have one homozygous, which is one C, one double C. Then two heterozygous, which is two, then two double, two C. Then one homozygous, as well, which is the small plants, one C, T. This is one ratio, two. One, you can see it here. So that's for the genotype. Okay, what about the phenotype? The phenotype is now just follow along. The phenotype. The phenotype is now what? 3:1. Half. How is 3:1? Because if you notice this 3, this 3 have was tall plants. This one has 1, 2, 3. There's an indication of tall plant, the big letter. So this is 1, 2, 3, which is 3 ratio, the short plant, 1. And that's the phenotype. That is what I just explained. How the first generation, and the second filial generation. This I just explained led to Mendel's first law of what? Inheritance. First law of inheritance also states that it's also called segregation of gene, the law of segregation of gene. What does this say? It states that genes are responsible for the development of what? New organisms, of individuals. That genes are responsible for the development of new organisms. And they are independently transmitted from one generation to another without undergoing any alteration. Genes are responsible for the development of new individuals and they are independently transmitted from one generation to another without any what? Alteration. So that's the first law of inheritance. Mendel's first law of inheritance. So this, for second law of inheritance, the Mendel's second law is going to lead us to diagram inheritance. But the diagram is for the first law of inheritance. Why would diagram is for second law of what? Inheritance. Okay, Gregor Mendel also carried out some other experiments. This time around, he crossed two different plants. He crossed plants which differs with two pairs of contrasting crater. The first one was one pair of contrasting crater. This time around, he's crossing one, which means a dihybrid, which means two pairs of what? Contrasting crater, such as the seed shape. I'm going to use seed this time around. The seed shape. Which become a round, which is just this was round and wrinkled. Then the seed color. The seed color which is yellow and green. So this one is for the hybrid inheritance. Okay. So what led to this? We call the whole setup the hybrid inheritance because it has two pair of contrasting characters. You can see them at the round and they call yellow and green. So that led to the hybrid inheritance. Firstly, cross the round and yellow. What it did was it crossed the round and yellow seeds. What has round and yellow? Round and yellow. It crossed the round and yellow seed with and pollinated it. You can have a yellow seed with those that has wrinkle and green. It crossed round and yellow seeds with wrinkle and green. The green and wrinkle, or wrinkle and green. And wrinkle and green, which is wrinkle and green. Let's use this one now. This is for round and yellow, then wrinkle and green. He crossed there. So the product he got was all, when he crossed there, the product he got was all round and yellow. And yellow seeds. The product he got was all round and yellow. The wrinkle and green did not show. Which in this is now was the dominant. Dominant inheritance. And I was saying, recommend they used was, he used two pair of contrasting characters. He used which is, he used seeds to seed shape and seed color. The seed shape here, this is here two pair here, round and wrinkled. So we are round and so we are wrinkled. While the color was yellow and green color seeds. So what he did was he pollinated both of them. Pollinated the round and yellow seeds with what? With the wrinkled and green seeds. When he pollinated it, the result he got was the result he got from those crossing was all round and yellow seeds. So this one is the dominant gene over the wrinkled and green seeds. So this round and yellow was for the first filial generation. So for the second filial generation, he crossed both the round and yellow together. Are you getting it? He crossed both of them together. And the result he got was from both both round and yellow in the ratio of 9:3:1. What he got was when he crossed the first failure generation plant, which is the round and yellow plants. The second generation, this is the second generation. It produced four types of plants.
some here, some here round and yellow, round and yellow seeds, ripple and green, ripple and yellow, sorry, then round and green, then ripple and green. That was the one to the second filial generation. Ripple and green. What you notice about this crossing or about this experiment is that it's always the gene always showed more in the second filial generation. It also shows the second filial generation. Because this is the product it got from before, which is so to this nine ratio nine, which is nine from round and yellow. Then ratio 3 from ripple and green, then 3 seeds from ripple around and green, then 1 from ripple and green. So all this experiment led to the stating of the second law of inheritance. Second law, recommended second law of inheritance, which is also called the law of independent assortment. Please notice they are all stated independently. It's also called the law of independent assortment, and it states that each character behaves as a separate unit. Each of them behave as a separate unit and are independently inherited. They are inherited independently of each other. They are separated towards independently, or they are independently from each other. They behave as a separate unit. Notice when you cross pollinate it. So on your own leisure, our guys will go and read it up to yourselves. We'll be like in essential biology, in modern biology, all about genesis. I'll stop here for now. The next week, continue from here. I stopped.